My name's Kevin Safara. I'm a professional musician. My instrument of choice is the drums. My ears and my hearing are my main tool for doing what I do. I have to be able to hear what's going on stage. When I do mixing and production, I really want to hear all the nuances in the music to the best of my ability. And with hearing loss, that's going to be affected. I know you can compensate for that. I'd rather not. I'd rather have my hearing to be pristine. And with fader plugs, it gives you true protection. But there's still something about it that when you have them in, you're still getting a little bit more definition of what's happening. And if you need more of that, you actually, like a fader would on a board, you either turn it up or you turn it down. You take these things and you turn them backwards and you're opening up basically what you could hear. And again, it seems like it's across the board. You're getting more high and more low. So it's not just real hissy, not real low. It's like you're just taking the volume of something and turning it up and then turning it down. And what's great about that is you don't have to take them out to do it.
My name is Adriano,
and I'm a DJ in Manhattan.
My average set can go anywhere from 3 to 5 hours on normal, so to have, you know, music at that volume, it gets pretty intense. So I definitely think it's important to have some kind of ear protection because you're exposed to it for so long. It's not, you know, just a fire truck going by. It's, you know, a constant decibel of sound throughout the evening. Looking at me straight on, you would never know that I even have them in at times, and depending on the color that you want, I mean, you can either show them off or you can go completely clear and not see anything at all. So if you are conscious, you know, of course, get yourself a clear pair. If you want to show them off, favorite color is red, black, blue, switch it up. And if I need to put my headphones back on to go back to work, I can leave them right where they're at, put my headphones on right over top of them, and no one ever knows the difference. Average club goer can, you know, easily be susceptible to ear damage, so I would definitely recommend fader plugs to anybody in the music industry or anybody that is a concert goer. To have ear protection is something that's really big.
My name is Eleni, I'm 24. I'm a young professional, you know, working, and on the weekends I like to go to clubs with my friends. Young people should really be using hearing protection, going to concerts, going to clubs. You don't usually realize how loud it is until the end of the night, you know, your ears are ringing. You know, you wear hard hats to protect your heads. You wear sunglasses and safety glasses to protect your eyes. You wear lab coats to protect your skin from cuts and burns, but you don't ever think about your ears. Fader plugs are the ideal choice of hearing protection for me because they have a sleek design. What's really cool about fader plugs is that you can actually control how much sound is coming into your ears. As a concert goer, I really want to be right in the middle of the action, and fader plugs really allows me to do that.
In February of 2015, I attended a hearing healthcare convention in Florida. And one of the speakers was talking about the pros of the big box stores now selling hearing aids. Hearing loss is often today linked to dementia, cardiovascular disease, an increased risk of falls. And I left the convention and I kept thinking to myself, how can I remove the fear and stigma from my age demographic and even older age demographics with regard to wearing hearing protection? And out of nowhere, bang, fader plugs.
Noise-induced hearing loss is the most common occupational illness in the United States, and in most cases, 100% preventable. Without hearing protection, we allow our auditory mechanism to be defenseless against an auditory assault, often resulting in ringing in the ears and or irreversible hearing loss.
We wanted it to be discreet, and we wanted it and needed it to be aesthetically pleasing. If you go to a bar or a club, if you're a concert goer, if you're a subway commuter, if you're a musician and you play in a band, or even if you're a hobbyist musician, protecting your hearing is so essential within all of those environments.
We've kept in mind that we wanted to somewhat mimic what happens naturally with the ear. The ear has its own very primitive protective device whereby when we hear loud sounds, there is a covering of one of the apertures to stop sound from entering into the cochlea where hearing loss and damage is done. This gate design is very much in keeping with that, not reflexive, but certainly a way in which to obstruct sound from entering into the cochlea where hearing loss and hearing damage occur.
With the fader plug, you have teeth on the bottom, and what you're able to do is we call it controlled noise attenuation. So as you turn, the teeth are interlocking. And what's happening is when you're turning, that gate door is closing a little bit more, and when it's fully closed, you're at maximum attenuation.
Fader plugs are the next step of the evolutionary process of today's hearing protection.
On behalf of Team Fader, I just want to thank you all for taking the time and watching our video and visiting our campaign. I would encourage you to join the team in spreading awareness of hearing conservation and preservation, and I can't wait for you to try out your universal and/or custom pair of Fader plugs.